gifts according to the grace given to each of us. Now, if your gift is prophecy, then prophesy in accordance with your faith. Verse 7, if it is serving, then serve. If it is teaching, then teach. Then he goes on and says, if it is to encourage, then give encouragement. If it is given, then give generously. If it is to lead, then do it diligently. And then if it is to show mercy, what do? You do it cheerfully. Bottom line, watch this. Bottom line, you have to understand that it's not the position you hold, it's the relationship you have. And I'm saying this because in life, positionally, based on a birth certificate, I am the biological father of three children in this world. But that doesn't imply that I necessarily am the father of these people. You see what I'm saying? I have the position to be the father, but it doesn't mean that I am the dad, that I have a relationship with them. The same thing applies in church. I can positionally be the pastor of the church, but that doesn't mean that I'm your shepherd. You may be a deacon in the church. So what? If you don't love the church, if you don't shepherd the church, you may be based on a certificate that you are the husband of this lady. She stopped loving you a long time ago. But you have the time. So this is why, on a Sunday like this, I'm just think about this whole issue that I'm describing to you, because what I'm asking you to do this morning is, and I don't know how to bring these things to you, but I'm going to show you the last one of four. When we first bought furniture at home, I already bought four of these babies right here. And the reason why we only have one left is because this guy arrived. So he arrived, and he took care of three. Now this right here is in a closet. And I went and looked for it this morning, and I said, I'm going to take it to church. Because if this baby was on a couch, these other babies will take care of this baby. And this baby will exist no more. Now, here's my point. When it comes to this grace and mercy, this humility, this mercy that when you look at yourself in the mirror and you see the law and you see how much grace God gives you. Because, by the way, how many of you know that God is constantly judging us? Think about it. He's constantly judging us. But you know what the difference with God? God judges each and every one of us for redemption. Otherwise, you would be dead right now. The only reason why you're here is not because you figured things out. It's because in his judgment, he continues to be patient with you. Amen. So when you look at this mercy of God, watch this, and you look at yourself in the mirror, and you see the log that you're carrying, now you have more compassion to look at the speck in your brother's or your sister's eye. And this is why, watch this, this is why I believe when it comes to the mercy of God, when it comes to the patience of God, when it comes to the love of God, many times God doesn't give it to us because we wouldn't know what to do with it. We will destroy it. That's why we have grown to be so judgmental. That's why we know in doctrine that we're supposed to forgive, but God, goodness, it's so difficult to forgive. And you make your own argument why you haven't forgiven. You make your own argument why you are still living with him instead of being married. Because, see, God wouldn't entrust you beautiful things because you're going to misuse them, just like this guy.